He has alienated me from my family. His mom wants me to leave him. I'm embarrassed to talk to my friends, and when I try to express how I feel to him, it turns into a fight. We have been together for 6 years and have 2 kids. It was delightful in the beginning. He was amazing. So kind, caring, and patient. He always did what I asked and then some. We talked about kids, our future, marriage, and everything else that comes along. We both lived with our parents as I was in school, and he was helping his mom because she was newly divorced and couldn't afford her house without him and his brother. Fast forward, I got pregnant with our first child. He immediately wanted me to quit my job, which I thought was him being nice and thoughtful because I was sick. But looking back now, I think it was a tactic to get me dependent early on. Nonetheless, we were so excited. I moved to his house, and we started saving for our own. Then slowly, as the pregnancy went on, he just stopped trying so hard. He didn't do anything bad. He just wasn't so thoughtful anymore and didn't include me in things anymore. He said he was stressed because we lived at his mom's house and were going to have our own child soon. While I agree we should have been on our own, his mom guilt-tripped him every time he tried to move, and we ended up staying. I had the baby, and postpartum was hard. I'm a stay-at-home mom, and he's traditional. He works, and I do everything for the baby, which slowly turned into everything for us, the baby and his mom and brother. This included laundry, dishes, and dinner for 5 people, 2 of whom were grown and not my responsibility. I did it because if I didn't and his mom had to, God forbid, fold her own laundry or wash her own dishes, she would walk around the house cursing and screaming that no one does anything around the house and that there needed to be some changes. Being downright crazy considering I was practically their live-in slave. Keep in mind we paid the majority of the bills, and his brother lost his job and was at home 24/7 as well. Then my boyfriend started to get insecure and felt like I had something going on with his brother, which we absolutely did not. He would flip his lid if I didn't spend every second of the day locked in our bedroom or the nursery. I had to keep a lookout for his brother and only come out to cook and clean when he was outside or asleep. Not that my boyfriend was there to know, but if he called or came home and saw us in the same area, I would hear about it for days. Full disclosure, his last girlfriend got caught with her stepbrother when they were together, so while not judging the insecurity, I'm not her, and it's very mentally hard on someone being locked within 4 walls all day, every day, plus having a toddler. We also found out I was pregnant again, and I finally said I couldn't take it. We packed up and moved to my mom's house until we could find a house to rent. This is where things took another turn. Shortly after moving, we had the second baby. Rather than just being unhelpful, he got mean. Obviously, it's uncomfortable living with someone else's mom. Trust me, I know I did it for a long time. But he used that as an excuse to yet again not help. The baby would wake up at 7 sharp and we would immediately be kicked out of the bedroom and sent away so he could keep sleeping. I would take both kids, even though a lot of times our toddler was still sleeping. I would have to wake him up, go make breakfast and lunch for my boyfriend. Then I would have to put it in his truck along with his coffee so he could leave without having to see the toddler and make him cry when he left. Once he left, I had to clean up breakfast, start on lunch, then deal with naps. While the babies napped, I did everyone's laundry, ironed his work clothes for the next day, and prepped dinner. The babies would wake up, we would play outside, and then cook dinner. After that, we'd take baths and go to bed. He would finally come home around 8:30, eat dinner, then shower and play video games for hours on end. I can say this schedule with confidence because it was an everyday thing, and if it didn't happen this way every single day, it was a huge problem, and I was made to feel like an idiot for whatever simple little thing wasn't done. We ended up quickly finding a house and moving an hour away from both of our parents, which I knew better than to do because we were not getting along at all. But he used the fact that he was stressed because we had a family and lived with other people as an excuse for his behavior, and stupidly, I accepted it. Again, there has been another turn. I'm not even allowed to sleep in the bedroom anymore. I sleep on an air mattress in the room with our 2 babies. They're in a toddler bed and a crib. He says he can't make money if he is getting up so often when I have to tend to one of the kids. We only have one bathroom, which is in the master bedroom. If I wake up at night or when I get up in the morning, I cannot go to the bathroom until he leaves for work, which is most mornings at 9. My kids still wake up at 7 sharp, so that's at least 2 hours holding my need to go. Not to mention my toddler is potty training, and we're struggling because we're not allowed into the restroom. Still, I get up and make breakfast, and then we have to go into the bedroom and lock the door so that my toddler doesn't stand at the door and cry for his dad. Finally, when he's about 10 minutes from leaving, I'm allowed to come out and make his lunch and coffee. Then he leaves. I don't really have a set schedule anymore. I just absolutely have to have the laundry done, the house clean, and dinner ready as he walks in the door. We eat as a family, and when he's done, he makes me put our baby to bed, and then as soon as she's asleep, I come get our toddler, and he goes to sleep. Then I have to get up, clean up dinner, iron his work clothes, and then shower and handle my personal needs. Now again, if the slightest thing is wrong, I get fully cussed out. I can't even put into words the things he does and says, the faces he makes, the snarky comments. He never puts his hands on me, but I know deep down this is emotional abuse. I know I need to leave, but I don't have a dollar to my name, and I have no access to our money except to pay bills and buy food, diapers, and gas, which I still have to ask for first. When I try to tell him what he's doing and how it affects me and our kids, he says I'm attacking him, that he's having a hard time, and that I'm only making it worse, and he somehow turns himself into the victim. Eventually, I just give up and retreat to the bedroom to lay down with my kids. I cannot go to my mom's house. His mom's house has a bad mold problem, so I can't take my kids there knowing that. And I can't stay here with him if I leave him. I honestly cannot afford to pay the rent on my own, and I wouldn't be comfortable letting my kids go with him without me, because he is verbally hurtful and really impatient with them too. I worry sometimes that he will snap and hurt one of us. So I'm really not sure where to go or what to do from here, and I really just needed to get it out. Please give me advice. Now, for a few comments before the update. Comment 1. Contact a woman's shelter and see what sort of resources they can connect you with. I'm not sure where you are, but we also have a number we can call. I believe it is 211 in Canada that connects you with other local resources as well. Start with the women's shelter and see if they have a spot for you and your children to go to. That's the first step. If you can, get your hands on whatever cash you can too. Stow it somewhere hidden and safe, even if you're just withdrawing $10 to $20 cash when you do groceries. Know that if you return, things are going to get worse. Best of luck, original poster. Comment 2. Poor dear. Hugs. That sounds like hell and slavery. Go here. Find your local shelter and ask for help. They should know how to help you get free without endangering you or the children. You may have to stay in a shelter for a bit, but frankly, it would be an improvement over your present situation. I wish you a better life. You deserve better. Now, for the update. Just over a month has passed since my last update, and things have only gotten worse. His controlling behavior got worse after he found out I was secretly looking for jobs. One night during dinner, he confronted me, demanding to know why I was always on my phone. I had been applying for part-time work that would fit around the kids' schedules. He accused me of being ungrateful for everything he provided, even though it was far from enough. One weekend, he invited friends over for a gaming marathon. Ignoring my need for help with the kids, I ended up managing the children while he enjoyed the night, feeling invisible in my own home. After a really rough night, I decided to reach out to my mom for support. She suggested coming over for a family dinner to talk about things in a comfortable setting. At dinner, I tried to share my struggles, but he interrupted, claiming I was exaggerating. During this time, my brother casually mentioned that he had seen my boyfriend out late one night. My brother noted that my boyfriend was with a group of friends, which raised eyebrows but was brushed off. Later that week, my boyfriend began to accuse me of being unfaithful, mirroring his own behavior. He started checking my phone when I wasn't around, making accusations based on nothing. After a heated argument, He smashed a plate, which startled the kids. The next day, I took the kids to a nearby playground. While at the playground, I overheard another mother talking about a local shelter. This gave me the idea of finding a safe space for me and the kids if things continued to get worse. Later that week, I went to a family gathering at my aunt's house for Easter. At the gathering, family members noticed my exhaustion and asked about my well-being. After the gathering, my aunt pulled me aside, offering a listening ear. A few days later, my boyfriend found out I spoke to my aunt and exploded with anger. He accused me of seeking sympathy and told me I should be ashamed. I decided that I couldn't keep living like this and started planning my exit strategy. I began to discreetly gather essentials for myself and the kids. I found a small bag in the back of the closet to hide away extra clothes and important documents. On a really tense evening, I overheard him on a phone call, sounding secretive and defensive. The next day, I took the kids to a library to look into resources for single parents. I learned about local programs that could help with housing and support. The final straw came when he demanded I quit looking for jobs and stay home instead. I stood my ground, telling him I wouldn't give up on my independence. That night, I packed a bag for the kids and myself, planning to leave while he was asleep. The next morning, I quietly left the house with the kids, heading toward my mom's place for safety. Things are still complicated, and I know this won't be an easy road ahead. My boyfriend has already started to reach out, trying to talk things over, and I know the kids will be caught in the middle of this. I really hope the kids can adjust to this new life and that we can get some peace. I'll make sure to post an update if anything big happens. Edit. A recent incident has made things even more concerning. My boyfriend showed up at my mom's house unexpectedly, demanding to see the kids. He tried to convince my mom that I was lying and that he was a great father. My mom stood firm, but I'm now worried about more attempts to see the kids. Am I the idiot for refusing to let my mother's husband control my life and stand up for myself? My mother and my father separated when I was about 5 years old. I still see my father a lot. I like him, and my parents are still nice to each other and like each other. They just didn't want to be married anymore. My mother and I lived by ourselves after that, and I'd stay with my father every couple of weeks, and I was happy with that. My father remarried when I was about 12, but I didn't mind. I like his wife. She's really nice, and she doesn't have a problem with me. But I don't like my mother's husband. They met at work and started dating when I was 12. They got married when I was 15, and we moved into his house. I didn't want to do that, but my mother wanted to, so I didn't really have a choice. They had a baby a year after that, a boy, and he's a bit annoying, but all right. My mother is also kind of pregnant with another baby, about 3 months along, and although I love her, she doesn't listen to me about her husband. I think the first time my mother's husband started acting like this was when I was about 16. I was showing my mother a bikini that I wanted to buy because I was going to Greece with my friends in the summer after school, and my mother's husband came in, and when he saw it, he said that it was inappropriate and he would never allow his daughter to wear that in public. I said that it was a good thing I wasn't his daughter then. He yelled at my mother that she had raised a slutty little girl. And while I was living in his house, I was going to have to fix my behavior and attitude. My mother said at the time that she didn't have a problem with it and I could wear it if I wanted, but she stopped defending me like that after a while. I wasn't allowed to wear anything cropped or tight. I couldn't drink. I couldn't go out late. I couldn't even stay overnight with friends. So I missed out on lots of things. And my mother just let him and would just say, "It's because he cares about me," or something. In some ways he did. He would help me with school, and he'd let me have foods like ice cream when my mother wouldn't. But he's still horrible. He doesn't hurt me. The only time he did was when he slapped me in the face because he wasn't letting me wear a dress I liked when I went out with my friends because it was inappropriate and would be asking for something to happen. I said that maybe if he thinks it's inappropriate to other people, they should be better at controlling themselves. I told my mother, but like usual, she just said, "It's because he cares about me." I'm not even allowed to not wear a bra in the house, when it's literally my home. It's not like it's affecting anyone, and it's way more comfortable. I know my father doesn't like him, but that doesn't really matter anymore, because my mother has stopped listening to him at all. My mother's husband definitely doesn't like him. He's always saying horrible things about him, and how my mother was stupid for even marrying him, and that his new wife is just a bad person. Which she's not. She's really cool and really smart. I hate him, and I hate living with him. I just want him to relax and not overreact to everything I want to do. I know I probably sound like I'm some kind of really inappropriate person, but I'm definitely not. I never dressed that badly, even though he acts like I did, and he's reformed me or something. I'm not even really allowed to talk to my mother anymore privately, because I used to talk to her in our language, which he doesn't understand because we're from different countries. He says it's rude and disrespectful to him, but he's the one who was too lazy to learn it. I just want to be able to make my own decisions, but when I say that, he says that I'm too young and I don't understand what's appropriate, and I don't know what to do about that. Now, for a few comments before the update. Comment 1. You can't get him to relax because he's not acting this way because of a misunderstanding. He's an hurtful, violent, controlling misogynist, and you need to get out. You should not be worrying about your mother. She's an adult. You're 18, and you need to be fitting your own oxygen mask. Seriously, consider moving to be with your dad. You'll make new friends. Failing that, ask at school for help in support to leave an hurtful household. This guy is a physically and verbally hurtful man who is aggressively sexualizing you and who blames women who are sexually attacked. This is not a safe situation for you at all, and is only going to get less safe as his wife's pregnancy progresses. You need to prioritize leaving. Comment 2. He doesn't hurt me. The only time he did was when he slapped me in the face because he wasn't letting me wear a dress I liked. So he does hurt you. You're 18. You need to get out. Now for the update. A week after the slap, my mom announced a family dinner for her birthday at a local Italian restaurant. Sounds innocent enough, right? Yeah, well, it wasn't. My stepdad insisted that we all dress formally for the occasion, but of course, he had to set strict guidelines for my outfit. He's like the fashion police or something. I picked out a simple dress and some shoes, nothing crazy, but he immediately criticized my choice, saying it was too casual. I mean, it was just a birthday dinner, not the Oscars. But whatever. He demanded I change into a more formal outfit that he approved of, which just added to the tension before we even got to the restaurant. When we arrived at the restaurant, the atmosphere felt awkward. I knew everyone could sense my stepdad's controlling vibe, but no one really said anything. The family gathered around a large table, and my younger sister had made these adorable handmade cards for my mom. She's always so thoughtful, unlike my stepdad, who just makes everything uncomfortable. In the middle of dinner, my stepdad interrupted to make a toast. He was all praises for my mom, but then he threw in some subtle digs at my contributions to the family. Like, thanks for making me feel like crap in front of everyone. During dinner, he suggested that I should be grateful for my mom's new life and support her choices. I mean, what the hell? I'm not some ungrateful brat. I just wanted to be a part of my mom's life, but he acts like I'm a freaking intruder. I tried to join the conversation like a normal person, but my stepdad cut me off. I wanted to talk about college and my summer plans, but no idiots here. He just dismissed everything I said. As the night went on, he made these inappropriate jokes about my clothing choices, like what was wrong with the simple dress I picked out. My older brother Jake, who's usually quiet and keeps to himself, finally spoke up and defended me. I didn't even expect that from him. But then my stepdad got visibly irritated and called Jake overprotective. Things escalated when they started arguing about respect and boundaries. I mean, come on, it's just a birthday dinner. My mom tried to mediate, but she ended up siding with my stepdad, saying everyone should chill out. Like, no, we should not chill out on your controlling jerk of a husband. I felt so unimportant at that moment. I left the table to go to the restroom and overheard my stepdad and mom arguing. He was accusing her of not controlling me properly and demanding she take a firmer stance. What does that even mean? Take a firmer stance? I'm not a child that needs to be controlled. I just want to be respected. When I returned to the table, the mood had definitely shifted, but no one acknowledged the tension. The birthday cake arrived, and everyone sang, but I felt so disconnected from the celebration. After blowing out the candles, my stepdad suggested a family trip, but I said no. I just didn't want to deal with him anymore. That's when he lashed out at me, calling me selfish for not wanting to join the family. I left the restaurant early, feeling defeated and unheard. Back home, my stepdad confronted me, questioning my choice to leave the dinner. He raised his voice, bringing up my disrespectful behavior toward the family. I tried to explain, but he just dismissed my words, insisting that I'm too sensitive. My mom entered the room, trying to calm things down, but she took his side again. This happens all the time, and I'm so sick of it. I told them I needed space and decided to go to my dad's house for the weekend to escape the tension. Upon arriving at my dad's house, I found comfort in the relaxed atmosphere. My dad asked about the dinner, and I shared the highlights and the conflict with my stepdad. He expressed concern over my stepdad's behavior, saying I deserve to be respected. It felt good to hear that, honestly. I just want someone to understand what I'm going through. After the weekend, I returned home to find the atmosphere still tense. My stepdad confronted me about skipping out on family time, which just escalated the conflict even further. My mom finally seemed to understand the tension, but she remained hesitant to take a stand. Things came to a head when my stepdad threatened to limit my time with my dad if I didn't comply with his rules. That's when I realized we needed to set clear boundaries with him, even though it might lead to more conflict. I just want to be treated like a human being and not some intruder in my own home. Edit. Things have changed since the dinner. I set boundaries with my mom and stepdad, explaining that I wouldn't tolerate disrespect anymore. My mom was upset but agreed on the condition that things stay calm. I also had a conversation with my dad about the importance of respect in my mom's house. He was supportive, even offering to help if needed. It's been tense, but I've noticed my stepdad's behavior improving slightly. We're working on finding a middle ground. Am I the idiot for confronting my wife about her secret spending and hidden hotel stays? My wife, who is 39 years old, lies all the time. We both work from home as statisticians, and we're either with each other or our one-year-old daughter all day. So, because I know it will come up, I don't think she's cheating on me or anything like that. She lies about big things and small things. With the small things, like a chore getting done, she usually maintains that it was unintentional or that she was planning to get to it. With the bigger things, almost always financial, it generally comes down to her making a mistake or a haphazard decision and then not letting me know about it because, according to her, I'll think she's careless, which she can be, and stupid, though she's genuinely brilliant. I'm not a mean husband. I don't talk down to her, and I don't yell, shame, embarrass, or hold it against her when she makes mistakes. I'm pretty hands-off with her money choices because most of our money is actually her money. She made some really savvy investments in her 20s, and she funds our lifestyle well beyond what either of us could afford on our salaries alone. I'm very fortunate to be her partner, and I'm very grateful for her. Other than the lying, she's a great partner and an incredible mom. She's not particularly domestic, but I don't think that's her responsibility alone. She'll often pay to have someone pick up the slack for tasks she's not great at. I like doing domestic, homey work because it makes me feel closer to my daughter and like I'm pulling my weight. Regarding the financial lies, they always come to light because I'm in charge of our banking, and I try to be thorough to make sure we're on top of our incoming and outgoing accounts. It's not like she carries rotating credit card debt. She just acts a little rich sometimes. Like she'll buy something pricey, such as a major home appliance, without any price comparison, or she'll agree to hire the first contractor she talks to without doing any research into the pricing. Then when I ask, she'll give an inaccurate quote of the price according to what she thinks I want to hear. It's never compromised us financially. I just find it kind of offensive as a kid from a working-class background. For what it's worth, she is from an equally blue-collar background. She had a pretty unstable and unsettling childhood. Her parents both died before we met, so I never saw the dynamic firsthand. But I think it's a big part of why she lies. She's in therapy, and she is working on the fear response and anxiety that contribute to her lying. Here's my issue. Not being able to trust her is exhausting. I never know what's true and what's not true, and I feel like I have to secretly keep close tabs on her so that I know truth from lie right away. It's laborious, and even though I tell her what I'm doing, it feels squirrely. I don't like feeling like I need to catch her. I want to be patient and give her the grace and support to heal, but I'm coming a little unwound. She recently made a really large family purchase of more than $100,000, and I asked her to review the details with me in advance. The purchased item was planned, as was her getting to purchase according to her preferences. The ultimate cost was not. She kept avoiding a sit-down, and I knew something was up. When I called it out, she pretended first that it wasn't as expensive as it was, and then afterwards, bizarrely insisted that she was pretty sure we had talked about it. It was like being lied to by a 5-year-old. I don't know what to do. I'm tired of playing private eye with my wife, but the lying is constant and compulsive. Any words of wisdom? Has anyone ever seen their partner do the work and recover from compulsive lying? I'm worried about the way this might impact our daughter, but it's not like divorce wouldn't carry its own instability with it. That's not really something I'm aiming for either. Separately, and maybe unimportantly, I worry about not being able to provide for our daughter in the way her mom would be able to. I also am trying to keep it in perspective. I wouldn't have any of the expensive things I do without my wife. That's not why I'm with her, but it makes me wonder if I'm overreacting to her dishonesty or not being sufficiently thankful for what she does for me and our family. Now for a few comments before the update. Comment 1. OP, if the house and car or cars are paid off, can you both agree to put 1 to 2 years of combined salary in a long-term savings account for in case of dire need, and then put your salary in savings each month to top that up? That way you will both be okay, and you can feel safe enough to just stop worrying about losing everything. It is very stressful when you are used to worrying about money to try and stop. But if you truly do not need to worry, think how awesome it will be to stop and how refreshing it will be for your wife to not feel she needs to lie to cover up entirely non-problematic spending. Comment 2. It seems like she is operating on the principle that it's easier to ask forgiveness than to get consensus. I know for sure that if the situation were reversed and you were the one lying, Reddit would rip you apart. They would call you overly controlling just because you contribute more to the family financially. So, isn't that what she is doing? Would she make big financial decisions of over $100,000 without discussing it if you were the one who made the bigger financial contributions? If the answer is no, it may be a lack of respect issue. Now for the update. Here's the update. Last time I posted, I was dealing with my wife's constant lying about money. It's been a rough few months, and I need to vent and see what others think. The day after my wife bought something without discussing it with me, I was going through some papers on the kitchen counter when I found a receipt for a fancy restaurant. It was hidden under a pile of stuff, and when I saw it, I just felt this familiar mix of frustration and exhaustion. The total was way higher than any dinner we would have at a place like that, and it was not even a restaurant we had talked about going to. I asked her about it, and she said it was a work dinner with colleagues. I checked her work calendar and saw no mention of a dinner or anything. I planned to ask her about it while we were prepping dinner, but she just changed the subject and avoided the topic altogether. That's when I decided I needed to keep a closer eye on her spending habits. A week later, we went to a family gathering for my parents' anniversary. My wife seemed really nervous talking to my sister, who's known for her personal questions and curiosity about other people's lives. Over dessert, my sister casually said how great it was that we recently dined at that fancy restaurant. I turned to my wife, and she just stammered and insisted she forgot to mention the dinner. It was so obvious she was lying, and I could see my sister picking up on it too. After the party, when she went to take a shower, I searched through her phone. I found texts about planning the dinner, and they showed She had been talking to a friend about how to keep it all a secret. When I brought it up, she just said it was a harmless dinner and that I was overreacting. I mentioned the texts, and she flipped out about me invading her privacy. The argument got really heated, and she stormed off to our daughter's room, leaving me alone in the living room. Days went by, and I noticed she continued to make small purchases without talking to me about them. One evening, she told me she bought a designer purse on a shopping app. When I confronted her, she said it was a necessary purchase for her mental health. I started documenting her purchases and matching them against our budget, just to see where all our money was going. It was getting ridiculous. One day, I got a call from my brother. He mentioned an upcoming family vacation and casually said that my wife had told him we were planning to join them. I was just done at that point. I confronted her about it, and she admitted to booking the vacation, but insisted it was a surprise for our daughter. I agreed to go, but secretly planned to keep tabs on her spending during the trip. The family vacation came up, and we stayed at a rental home. My wife seemed really distracted. She would sneak off during the day, saying she needed alone time. I decided to follow her one afternoon, just to see what she was actually up to. Turns out, she was meeting a friend at a nearby cafe, not doing any self-care like she claimed. After the trip, I found another receipt for a hotel stay in her bag. When I confronted her about it, she finally admitted to spending some time away from home to escape the stress. That's when I booked a weekend getaway for myself and our daughter to the same hotel she visited. I framed it as a family bonding trip, and she reluctantly agreed to stay behind and work. I took our daughter to the hotel, and we had a great time together. While we were there, I found out from the staff that my wife had stayed there multiple times over the past few months. I returned home, feeling more determined than ever to confront her again. I had proof of her deception, and I was done being in the dark about her lies. The thing is, I don't know how much more I can take. Edit, I revealed everything to her. She confessed to being with an ex-colleague and admitted it started as an affair but turned into a friendship. She's now choosing to end it. If you like this video, you'll probably like these too. Also, while you're here, please consider subscribing. It's your support that keeps this channel alive and allows me to make better and longer videos. Have a great day.